Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. So as you guys said that in my Instagram poll that you want to see the Maybelline Superstay foundations review first, here I am with it. And before starting, if you're new to my channel, hi, I am Megha. So I make videos on beauty, DIYs, jewelries and whatever comes to my mind. So, and also I can make videos on whatever you want, so make sure you leave it in the comment section below. I'll make sure that I do it. And also do not forget to subscribe if you haven't and hit the notification bell as well. So without further ado, I wanna just address few points that today is a very cloudy day, so there's no sunlight. You might face some kind of light issues. And also right now I don't have anything on my face. I just did my brows and applied a lip gloss. So yeah, let's get started. So this is how the Maybelline foundation looks. So yeah, this is how the foundation looks. Here it says Superstay 24 hours foundation. And I have tried and tested this product. I was telling you guys about it that I won't review it until I know what this product is. So for those people who want a comparison between the Fit Me and the Superstay, I have both of them with me. So a quick disclaimer, Fit Me was my first foundation that I ever bought, and before that I did not use any foundation. I still don't like using heavy foundations. So Fit Me being my first foundation, I picked a horribly wrong shade for my skin tone. So my skin tone is actually 128 warm nude, and for the Fit Me one I chose 230 natural buff, which is so orange. So you can see both of them right here. You can see this one is a lot more warmer, and it just did not suit me. So I just thought that it's not for me. And somehow, you know, when you don't know anything about makeup and you just pick something up. So yeah, that happened. And after that, I did use this foundation, but also when I picked this up, I was really tanned. So yeah, that blunder happened. So the main similarity between these two are that these are matte foundations, and they are, I wanna say they are meant for oily skin people, because this is also a matte poreless foundation. So this says that this is a normal to oily skin foundation, and this is also the same. But then the difference starts from the packaging. First of all, this is a lot more taller, this bottle. Also, it comes with a pump, which is amazing because I have faced a lot of problem with Fit Me. You can see how messy it becomes and how much product we end up wasting. This bottle looks gross. Just look at that. It has so much product. It has so much product wasted, and the cap and all, it starts spilling. So I'll just show you the shade differences first, and also these oxidize. So this is 230 natural buff. You can see it's not my shade. And then here we have my shade, that is 128 warm nude. So yeah, that's my shade. Then of course this one comes with a pump, which is really nice, but I kind of have problem with the pump because it's not tight. So I'll just show you. Look at that. It rotates, and when you kind of try to spill it, you will feel like, oh my god, this is breaking. So yeah, the similarities between them, as I told you guys, are that they are both for oily skin people. Of course, dry skin people can use it. I have used this, and I use this right now. Everybody can use it, but of course the primers will be different, which is my next topic that I'm going to tell you guys. But yeah, they both are of 30 ml, so the quantity is also same. They haven't launched all the shade in India. As usual, they only have like fair shades to medium shades. They don't have dark shades, which sucks, to be honest. And then another main difference is this is full coverage. So 750 bucks and full coverage foundation is amazing. So coming back to primers, oily skin people, this is a blessing in a bottle for you guys. You can use any primer you want. Of course, I have two options for you, one drugstore, one high-end.
So this is
the Smashbox Photo Finish Primer. This is oil free. You can totally give it a shot under this foundation. I think if you have oily skin, it will just work great for you. And then the drugstore option is, which I use, this is the Lakme Blur Perfect Makeup Primer. Great, you can use it. The actual problem is for dry skin people, because this product is very matte, and this will dry out your skin if you don't have your like good moisturizer underneath and a good oil based or water based primer. So the two options I have for you guys is again, the high-end one is from Smashbox. This is the primer water, really nice hydrating on the skin. Or the Pat Studio Finish Oil Primer. I use this underneath this foundation, does not dries out my skin. And whatever primer works for you, basically you can use it. Make sure it's a little bit hydrating because this is gonna dry out your skin. So now we are going to see how it applies. So we are now up close and personal. I'm going to use this thing, but first I'm going to prime my face. I'm going to use two primers because I have really dry skin. And by the way, also I'm using two primers because I haven't moisturized my face. So I just took one pump and we'll see if this pump can cover our face. Of course, I already know if it does or not, but just for you guys, I'll just apply one side of my face with a brush, which I actually haven't done earlier. I have just used my blender, and now we'll see if this one pump can cover my entire face or not. Okay, so coming to the part that how long it lasts, it says it lasts for 24 hours. I'm not even going to try to do that because I don't wear foundation for so long. Like who will wear foundation for 24 hours, dude? But still, talking about the longevity, this is going to last you long. So many times, like when I was trying it out, say that I have applied it around 11 o'clock in the morning, and then at night I have washed my face around 9. Of course, it did get oily a little bit, just the slightest bit around my nose, so it cracked on my smile lines, but just the slightest bit. And that also I was checking it with a magnifying mirror, so you can see half of my face is covered. I'm going to take a flat brush. This is from Amazon. Okay, so with the brush, it kind of leaves the brush strokes. So with the brush, I'm not sure you guys can see or not, this kind of leaves brush strokes, but I like the finish. I think a denser brush would work nicer. I like my Beauty Blender. Beauty Blender always fixes everything. That was one pump, and I'm happy with how the skin looks. It's not too heavy. I can see a bit of redness right in here because I had some pimples. So I think I'm just going to try to layer it, but I'm not going to take a full pump. I'm going to take half a pump. So yeah, even though the foundation was pretty well set from the first layer, the second layer did not really apply patchy. I really like that fact. It did not move the foundation under me. So now I'll just quickly finish all my makeup and just be right back to you guys and talk more about it. So yeah, I have completed all my makeup. If you want to know what's on my face, you should check my Instagram. It's because I have filmed an Insta video on this look. And all the makeup details you will get there. And the link is down in the description box below. You can just go there, click on the link and follow me on Instagram. And coming back to this foundation, for oily skin people, this is your green card. Go ahead, do whatever you want with this foundation, you know, powder your face after using this, especially on these areas where you get oily. You can bake your face, you can just like use a compact, you can do whatever you want, only if you have oily skin. But for dry skin people, I won't really ask you guys to bake your face after you use this because this is a full coverage foundation and it's very matte. So it might just dry out your skin too much if you bake. What I have done is I've just used a concealer and I have set only those areas where I have put concealer. I haven't set my face. So you can see it looks pretty matte. This is the highlighter. But yeah, and also it does not transfer. So I'll just show you guys. So this is my phone screen. And now I'm going to press it against my skin and you guys will tell that if it transfers or not, but I know it does not, you know. So I'm just like holding it as if I would talk. Look at that, there is no transfer. There's something like obviously it will pick up some product, but this is definitely not the foundation. So that's a good thing. It is really long lasting. And of course, for the shade match, you can match your earlier Fit Me foundation with this. They are the exact same shades. So this product is not going to trash. This is gonna stay with me. I'm gonna use it and I truly love this product. And yeah, that's it for this review. And if you have any further questions, ask me in the comment section below. I always make sure that I reply to you guys. And yeah, stay tuned for more. And do not forget to subscribe. Till then, take care. Bye-bye.